state insurer PhilHealth, set to expand and introduce new benefits even as its scheduled hike this year, was ordered suspended by President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. The details from Vivian Gulia.
Outpatients undergoing hemodialysis may soon avail of expanded benefits from the Philippine Health Insurance Corporation. PhilHealth announced that it is set to increase this year its outpatient hemodialysis coverage to 156 sessions from the current 90. The State Health Insurers Benefits Committee has already approved the expanded coverage, and the board is set to tackle the matter before the end of the month.
This increase in the number of sessions covered is based on standards for adequate dialysis, which requires 3-4-hour sessions every week for chronic kidney disease stage 5 patients.
Ledesma adds PhilHealth is providing 270,000 pesos in financial support to patients on peritoneal dialysis and 600,000 pesos for renal patients qualified under Z benefits for kidney transplant. PhilHealth also plans to introduce this 2023 the outpatient benefit package for mental health and the outpatient package for severe acute malnutrition for children below 5 years old. Meanwhile, it will review the COVID-19 benefit packages, aiming to rationalize particularly the inpatient packages, RT-PCR and rapid antigen tests, and isolation packages.
Aligning with the new protocols and treatment guidelines, we will also rationalize our benefits. So, yun pong rationalization could either mean pwede pong madadagdagan, pwede rin pong mababawasan, depende po ito ngayon sa mga magiging bagong protocols and guidelines.
PhilHealth's plan to introduce new and expanded benefits come even as it had to defer the scheduled hike in membership contributions this year in compliance with the order of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. The premium rate for PhilHealth was supposed to increase this 2023 to 4.5% from 4% based on Section 10 of the Universal Healthcare Act. If it pushed through, PhilHealth estimates that it would have earned an additional 17 billion pesos. Despite this, Ledesma assured the public, PhilHealth's cash flow is healthy and robust.
I think it's safe to say that at least for this year, the 0.5 for this year and for the 0.5 for next year, if ever again, masususpend, no? I think PhilHealth will be okay, no? Walang problema. We'll not only continue the benefits, gaganda pa.
PhilHealth says it posted a record net income of 46 billion pesos as of September 2022. This brings the corporation's total assets to 394 billion pesos, 13% higher than the December 2021 figures.
PhilHealth will definitely last. There is no limit po sa lifetime, lifespan ng PhilHealth.
Asked whether PhilHealth will invest in the proposed Maharlika Investment Fund, its president and CEO has this to say.
We all win PhilHealth anytime we can contribute or we can assist. We're very open. No? But of course, in our charter, it's very clearly stated it's not allowed.
PhilHealth says it is currently processing outstanding claims amounting to 11.9 billion pesos. And its average turnaround time in payment of claims is 29 days, well within the prescribed 60 days. Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.